Philippine Central Bank will close applications for new non-bank electronic money issuers, or EMIs, beginning December 16. Central Bank Governor Benjamin Jokno says the suspension will allow the BSP to facilitate a more focused supervision of the current EMI players. The Central Bank is supervising 65 e-money issuers, 35 of which are non-banks like PayMaya and GCash. The application window will be closed for 2 years.
There has been a dramatic shift in consumer behavior towards digital payments. Hence, we have to take a proactive stance in terms of safeguarding the public trust. Recalibrated approach in place, we hope to be able to continue employing timely risk mitigating actions and craft appropriate policies revolving around consumers' welfare and protection and secure financial system.
Philippine Central Bank Governor Benjamin Jokno appeals for calm as the Omicron variant continues to rattle financial markets, saying the reaction could be exaggerated. Let's hear more from Warren De Guzman.
Philippine shares were on a steep losing streak prior to Thursday's bounce. It was largely blamed on the new COVID-19 variant Omicron. Not much is known about Omicron yet, but the memory of how the Delta variant forced countries around the world back into hard lockdowns is still quite fresh. Central Bank Governor Benjamin Jokno, however, says he is not worried about it.
We will continue our accommodative monetary policy until needed by the national government. We're not so concerned with the new virus, or with the new variant, rather. I think there's too much exaggeration on the impact of that. I think the best thing to do really for the Philippines is vaccinate, vaccinate, vaccinate.
Meanwhile, Socioeconomic Planning Secretary Carl Chua spoke at a forum of the Asian Institute of Management advocating the treatment of COVID-19 as endemic, which assumes the virus will not go away and mobility restrictions should not be used to address it. In other words, he too is calling for more vaccinations to fight the pandemic. Whether or not that means there will be no more hard lockdowns in the Philippines remains to be seen. Some business groups lobbied hard against tighter quarantine restrictions when the Delta variant was sending cases to new highs in August and September, but government still locked down the national capital region. And while vaccination levels have certainly improved, the Philippines still ranked last in the Bloomberg COVID resilience ranking for a third month in a row in November. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.
Now, over in the U.S., Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen says the Omicron variant is proof the pandemic would persist for quite some time. But she hopes the continuing health crisis would not completely stifle economic activity, adding that the U.S. stimulus at the start of the pandemic helped fuel a very strong recovery. Yellen also said lowering Trump-era tariffs on imported goods from China through a revived exclusion process could help ease some of the inflationary pressures.
I think the pandemic has contributed in very important ways to the inflation problem that we're facing. And the Trump tariffs that were put in place, some of them create problems without having any real strategic justification. Our U.S. Trade Representative, Catherine Tai, has been working with the Chinese, reviewing the phase one trade agreement. And she's opened up a process in which firms can apply. It's called our domestic tariff exclusion process in cases where the cost to Americans exceed any benefits of the tariffs. This is a process by which tariffs can be lowered. And I think that that could be helpful. Again, it's not a game changer, but these are things we're doing to try to mitigate these pressures.
The Chinese government's advisors are recommending lowering the country's 2022 economic growth target amid growing challenges to the outlook. Three advisors told Reuters their own forecast ranges from as low as 5% to 5.5%, down from the above 6% target set for 2021. The world's second largest economy faces multiple headwinds heading into next year due to a property downturn and strict COVID-19 curbs that have impeded consumption. The new Omicron variant may also add risks, so investors are now closely watching for clues on next year's policy and reform agenda as President Xi Jinping and other top leaders hold the annual Central Economic Work Conference this month.